This is the video for section 29 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course and covers the pluperfect indicative active. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn, page 62, for their coverage of the material, and they go back to that in the appendix on page 662. The pluperfect indicative active is past time and completed aspect, and to form it, you take your stem from the fourth principal part, from which you subtract the alpha, and add the augment to the front since we're in past time, and then of course you add endings to give person and number. So here are the principal parts of Luo. We go to the fourth principal part. We take off that alpha to get our stem Leluk, and then we add the augment to it. Here's our chart for person and number, and here are the endings of the singular for the pluperfect, A, Ace, A. And the third singular can have a new movable. In the plural, we get emen, ete, eson. The accent is recessive. The default translation for the pluperfect indicative active is she had verbed. And that is what gives us past time and completed aspect in English. She had verbed. Pluperfect, then, is about actions that are over and done with from the point of view of sometime in the past. Even though these are new endings, you can see some familiar things, like the sigma at the end of the second person singular, and the men as the person marker for we, and te as the person marker for y'all. They just go with different characteristic vowels in the endings of the pluperfect. So let's put this together. Principal part 4, endings, recessive accent, all of which need to have the augment at the beginning. So here in all the persons and numbers is the augment and principal part 4. A, ace, a, or ain. Emen, ete, eson. Now, recessive accent. We look at the last syllable of the word. We can see that it's long, and we count back 1, 2, and put in an acute over the second to last. Again, we get long, so we go back 1, 2, and we have an acute over the penult. Long, 1, 2, acute over the second to last. In the plural, we have a short last syllable here, so we count 1, 2, 3 to go back as far as an acute can go. Then, again, short, 1, 2, 3, and acute. Short, 1, 2, 3, and acute. And that's the whole conjugation. This is eleluke, which means I had freed. Eleleukes, you had freed. Eleleukein, she had freed. Eleleukemen, we had freed. Eleleuketa, y'all had freed. And eleleukesan, they had freed. Little side note, don't get confused by this ain ending. You've seen that ending before on the present infinitive active, to free, or to be freeing, but that's from the first principal part, so they should be easy to tell apart. Okay, let's try the pluperfect with another verb. How about our old friend paideuo? And here's a chart and its six principal parts. We go to the fourth principal part, take off that alpha, we make sure to add the augment at the beginning, and then we have the stem, plus our ending, plus our accent, and we get epepaideuke, I had educated. Augment, stem, ending, accent, epepaideukes, you had educated. Augment, stem, ending, accent, epepaideukein, she had educated. e pepidelk emen with the accent e pepidelk emen we had educated. Augment, stem, ending accent, epipidelketa, y'all had educated, and finally, epipidelkeson, they had educated. And that's the pluperfect indicative active. Memorize those forms, and you should be ready for drills, classwork, and translations.